Hello friends. So until last video, we saw theoretical concepts to get started with Flutter. So from this video, we'll start with a coding implementation of the Flutter version. So first of all, we'll take with the default code when we create a new project. So this is the default code, but we skipped for initial understanding. So I'll back with the previous initial default code that Flutter provided for us. If you run this code, it will basically show an application screen with a floating action button with a text counter in it. Whenever we click that counter button, the counter text in the center will start incrementing its value. Basically, we are having one local variable. We are assigning that variable to state. Whenever we are clicking that floating action button, that state value will get updated. Updated state value get reflected in the text which we are showing. So that is the basic flow. We'll try to explore since we haven't seen any code yet. So basically remaining things will remain same, like import, void, main, run app, everything will remain same. But then here comes the new class called My Home Page, which extends stateful widget. So until now we saw how stateless widget will be. There's nothing in stateless widget. We are extending stateless widget, and we'll have we will return one build method which returns a widget. That is what until we see now. But now here stateful widget, it should create one state for that particular screen. So whatever widgets we are placing inside this My Home Page, it may either be complete entire screen or maybe the part of screen. Whatever may be, we should create one state for that particular widget. So here we are creating, instead of directly overriding build method like what we do in previous stateless widget, here what we have to do is we have to create one state. We have to create state for that. Creating state. And it should be of type state. This state should be of type something else. We can create one more class here. So this My Home Page, this is a type state of type My Home Page, and we are creating one state. That state is returning one constructor, one class that's called My Home Page State. So this is the class. Again, it creates one more class, returns a state variable of that particular class type. Okay. If we come into this class, we are extending from state My Home Page. This is not stateful widget. This is the stateful widget. Inside that class, we are having one more overridden method, create state, that returns state of type that same class. Inside that, we are calling this constructor. Once you come inside this, we are extending state of that particular class My Home Page. It extends state of that particular class which we are from where we are coming. Inside that, for now just ignore this in counter value and ignore everything. We are having similar build method which returns a widget which takes context as a parameter. Inside that same, we are returning one scaffold widget. We'll see the scaffold widget in later part of video or in next video. Inside the scaffold widget, we have one property called app bar. We are having one widget called app bar. Inside that, we are having some title and then body, center tag, child, column, everything we have inside that main axis. Main axis alignment is for column, which we'll see later. We come into core logic of that state implementation. Okay. For now, just ignore this text and everything. We'll come into floating action button first. So what is floating action button? So floating action button is the button which is placed at bottom of the screen that do not overlap with the underlying content. As the name suggests, it's floating above the screen. By default, it's placed at the bottom of the screen, bottom right corner of the screen. So this floating action button is a part of scaffold widget, which we are going to see in upcoming videos. The scaffold widgets have one property called, apart from this app bar and body, we have one property called floating action button. That floating action button, we can use that same floating action button widget, and we can have whatever we need inside. Inside that, we have three properties: child, tooltip, and onPress button, onPress function. So child is basically what should contain inside that floating action button. Floating action button generally round in shape, and we can add whatever we want, either text or image or icon, whatever we need, we can add. We should give inside this child property. Child property contains an icon inside that we are adding an icon. So this is icon widget. Inside that we are giving one icon class and using that icon property. So this icon is class. Inside that we have multiple icons, whatever icons we need, some basic icons are added as a part of this Flutter library. One icon is this add icon. This add returns a plus icon. That icon constant, that variable is passed into this icons widgets. So that icon widget basically convert that string class method into a basic icon. So this is icon. This icon class has lots of icon. If you go to this icon widget, it contains this dot icon, key size, color, semantic label, text direction. So these are the properties that we can give for particular icon. For example, for icon, not only give icon to that, we can add size for that and color for that. By default, we'll take a black color. If you need icon in any specific color, you can change the color of that icon to the desired color which we need. By default color of the icon which we added is white, and the floating action button color is blue, which is coming from this this primary swatch blue color. So that's where we are getting this blue color. This blue color is coming from this theme, so everywhere it will reflect the same blue color. Okay, once this floating action button is done, we have tooltip increment, just to tell this button is increment button. Usually don't see that increment text. And we have one more function called onPressed, one more keyword called onPressed. We have to pass function or callback to this onPressed method, onPressed keyword. We have one function called increment counter. When you click this function, it will go to that function declaration. So here we are declaring one function called increment counter. It returns nothing, so we are having void and it takes no parameter, so we are leaving this parenthesis empty. Inside, if you open this curly braces, we have one function called set state. If you hover this set state, this state is actually for changing the state. Notify the framework that the internal state of this object has changed. So whenever the state object getting changed, we have to pass this function to whenever we need some data of the particular screen to be changed, we have to pass inside the state value. Set state, we have to change that variable to that new variable so that existing state will get updated immediately. So here what we are doing is, here we are incrementing counter. So we have one local variable called counter. By default it's assigned to 0. Here this value is 0. And inside this text, if you see this column, this text is coming from this here. You have pushed this button this many times, colon, and again in more one more text. So this, as we saw, this column layout can have multiple children. So one of the children is text and one more children is another text. Here, since the text is const, we're having this const keyword, but this text is variable, so we don't have any const keyword. Inside this text, we are having one variable called counter. This variable is basically the local variable which we declared here, this counter. Since we are adding, we are printing that value, we are using this dollar inside the single quotes. That value we are printing, and this text has few more properties called style. We can have whatever style we want. A basic default style is this style and text sizes, the text which we are seeing here. If we need to change the color or text size, we have to give additional properties like style, and we have few more properties we'll see later. For the style, we are giving theme of context dot text theme dot headline 4. For now, bear with this. We are having some more style so that text size is little bit bigger than the text we have in first line. Okay, we are just printing that counter. Initial value of that counter is 0. We are displaying the counter value so that it's displayed 0. So whenever we click this button, this onPress will get called. Increment counter will get called. In this increment counter, we have one function called set state. Inside that set state, we are incrementing counter. So incrementing counter value. So this basically the set state. So if you just increment this counter without calling the set state, there won't be anything happening because What the set state function will do is it will notify the Flutter application that there is a change in internal state. So I have to, if anything is changes, you have to re-render the component wherever needed. So this counter, assuming that this counter is a state variable, since we are incrementing inside the set state function, it assumes that this is a state variable. We have to re-render if there is any change. So counter initial value is 0. Whenever we call this function, counter will get incremented to 1. So this state, since we are using inside the set state, this assumes this is a state variable and we are using somewhere else. So that whenever there is a change in this counter value, since it's a state value, the place wherever we are using will get render, re-render. So this text basically get render once again. Now this counter value is 1. So it'll get reflected here. So see, if you press this button, this value get updated to 1. See here, this increment counter will get called, and then set state, inside the set state we are incrementing counter. Since it's a counter is a state variable, wherever we are using that state variable will get updated. So this text getting updated to 1. If you press again, it will get updated to 2, then 3, then 4. So how much our time we are pressing, it will get incremented accordingly. So this is the basic state concept. Initially we are extending with a stateful widget, and then we are creating one state which returns a state of same type, and inside the new class we are having same scaffold function. We are returning on build method inside that scaffold widget. Inside that we need whatever logic we need to have, we can have, and we need to have one local variable, and if you need to change that variable and it should reflect, we should add inside the set state. Since we are incrementing this value, we are giving counter. If we have to assign the something else, we can give here equal to some value, so that it will get updated accordingly. Okay, we'll leave it as is. This is the basic implementation which Flutter gives. This explanation for that. With this, we are little bit familiar with the stateful concepts and stateless concepts. That nothing in stateless, we can do whatever we want without having any dependency on the state variables or state changes. In stateful widget, we have state variables. It shouldn't be only one variable. We can have n number of variables or keywords. It shouldn't be a number. It can be string. It can be whatever we need. It can be object. We can update that object. So whatever we need, we can put it inside the state variables, and we can update wherever we need it. So this is a basic stateless and stateful concept. So why we are seeing the stateful concepts before starting another widgets is, maybe some of the widgets which we are going to use in future may contain stateful variables and stateful concepts is needed to understand that. So that is the reason why we are introducing stateful concept before starting another widget. So in the next video, we'll start with the scaffold. So basically this widget, we are using the scaffold widgets to start with the basic implementation of the widget screen. So we'll see what are the methods other than this app bar body, floating action button we have, and we'll go deep into that each and every widget we have inside the scaffold. Thank you.